Hey man, what's going on man? It's your boy Kai Gets MG back with another video, man. And today, you can tell by the thumbnail, you can tell by the title, exactly what's going on, man. Today, coming at y'all with that Q&A video, man. I made the little 50,000 subscriber special about a week ago, I want to say, man. And I said I wanted to do a little Q&A, man. So I put out on all my socials, ask me questions, personal, gamer related, anything like that, man. And we actually got a lot of questions, you know what I'm saying? This is actually my first Q&A, so I guess I'm just gonna jump right into it, man. I do want to start off by saying thank y'all. I can't thank y'all enough. I'm truly blessed to have y'all, grateful for y'all. I love y'all, man. Now let's keep going up. I guess I'll just start off by saying some of the things I guess new subscribers would want to know coming into this channel. This is a gaming let's play channel, as well as reactions and discussions to any game, pretty much. I'll play anything that's fire y'all want to see, that I like, you know what I'm saying? And I'll let you know some of the games you're gonna play before we play them. My name is Brandon and I'm 19 years old. Now let's get into the questions. Like I said, it's a lot of questions, so I'm gonna try to, you know, get through a lot of these. Some of them are duplicates, so I'll try to answer. Some of my answers might go to multiple questions, so let's get through this as fast as possible. First off, we're on Instagram, man. We got the homie Suwasalis. He asked, who inspired you to start doing YouTube? I actually never really was inspired to start doing YouTube from other YouTubers. I'm inspired by YouTubers now, you know what I'm saying? Berlizzi, the Rad Brad, Corey Kenshin, you know what I'm saying? Those three right there are probably the biggest influences of what I'm doing right now. But when I started YouTube, it was actually, I used to make GTA 5 music videos and edits, as you can see. I think I got a couple of them up are still on the channel, but I used to do those things just for fun, you know what I'm saying? Put little memes in the background. One of my friends was actually like, just upload them on YouTube, you know what I'm saying? So I did that. It's just like a little joke thing. And with that, you know what I'm saying, I started to make AMVs, and that got me to around 3,000 subscribers. So I'm like, hold on, maybe I can keep doing this. The thing is though, I never truly wanted to do that, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, I started doing it as a joke, but that wasn't my passion, I guess. My passion was gaming. So when I started to flip that switch, that's when the Berlizzi, the Rad Brad, and Corey Kenshin came in as my inspirations for the gaming. Next question, man, we got is from K-Bucks. I guess that's how you say it, K-Bucks. He says, did it affect your family, and did they tell you that you can't be successful? No, actually, you know what I'm saying? When I said I started my YouTube channel for the AMVs and GTA music videos, that was actually the end of 8th grade. So that goes to show that I really wasn't trying to do anything. It was in the 8th grade, going into high school. I wasn't planning on being a, you know, a gaming big YouTuber at the time, man. So I didn't tell my parents, you know what I'm saying? It wasn't a big thing. But through the years, you know what I'm saying, it was my senior year. I just graduated. I was actually out with my mom, man, and I was already planning on telling her, because I saw where this could be going. You know, this pandemic hit, I graduated, I was out of school. I'm like, I love games. I can play games. I love games. Why not make a career out of this? You know what I'm saying? Once again, with my inspirations being the Rad Brad, Berlizzi, and Corey Kenshin. So I was in the car with my mom. I told her. She was proud off the bat. You know what I'm saying? No questions about it, because, you know, me and my mom and my family, we have a pretty good relationship, and, you know, we bring each other up with what we want to do. We follow our dreams without having to, you know, work for anybody else. You know what I'm saying? We're very independent people. So she was proud to see that I was, you know, starting, y'all, because I was starting to make money off of it. That's when I showed her. I'm like, okay, I'm starting to make a little money. Let me go ahead and tell the parents that, you know, this is probably going to be the move right here. And I wanted to do it. You know what I'm saying? This isn't something I didn't want to do. And yeah, she was pretty proud. Next up, man, the question is from JBloodWolf_YT. But he asks, how do you keep going when haters come at you? Simple. I just keep going. You ignore it. I've never been a person to, you know, be under pressure or get sad or depressed from hate comments. That's never been a big thing to me. I'm the type of person that just doesn't care much about anything when it comes to hate stuff. All the good comments, and, you know, that really means a lot to me. People saying that, you know, I'm funny, I've been making their day, that means a lot to me. When I see the hate stuff, you know what I'm saying, you know, it's at the end of the day, a comment is still helping. So regardless if it's hate, if it's good, if you're commenting on my channel, you're helping me out, so I appreciate you. Next up, man, the question is from Vadery with a multiple E's. It's like Vadery. It says, what Marvel characters would you like to see a game? Get a game. That's a good question, though. We had a lot of, you know, Marvel characters have games in the past, but I feel like a game a character that should deserve a new updated game in this day and age have to be Ghost Rider, man. The Ghost Rider game we had back then, it was smooth for that time, but imagine a Ghost Rider game by like Insomniac, bro. I feel like that would be heat. We're finally getting the Wolverine game by Insomniac, but Ghost Rider would probably be probably the character I want to see the most. And like I said, a lot of other characters had a lot of games already, but I would want to see them revamped or just a new standalone game for those characters, like Iron Man, Captain America, Thor, Fantastic Four. Y'all heard me say this a lot. I definitely want to see a Fantastic Four game get announced sometime soon, you know what I'm saying, in the future, especially with now that we have the Guardians, Wolverine getting a game, we got Avengers, Spider-Man. Definitely want to see a Fantastic Four game. Now over on YouTube, man, the question is from Talisman. He asks, what is it like having a video blow up on TikTok? Love your videos. Thank you, bro. What is it like having my video blow up on TikTok? It's actually wild, you know what I'm saying? One of my close friends, I was already planning on uploading my clips to TikTok, you know what I'm saying, for the exposure, you know what I'm saying, because at the time I wasn't really sharing clips like I should have been, you know what I'm saying. I was just uploading to YouTube, so I really started sharing stuff everywhere, Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook, like groups and all this, Reddit, and I finally downloaded TikTok and said, let me start sharing stuff here, and when I downloaded TikTok, man, and then my friend hit me up and said, you need to start sharing stuff to TikTok, it can blow you up. So when I heard him say that, it kind of just like, you know, in my head, I'm like, okay, I really need to start doing this. He was like a sign saying that I need to go ahead and start sharing these clips. And I started sharing clips over time, you know what I'm saying? People are starting to like it. I was getting followers on YouTube. And then one day, I was playing Spider-Man. I started singing that song. I wake up in the morning and I, you know what I'm saying? And it blew up. It's still going strong. It's like 7.4 million views on TikTok right now. For the original one, the sound is like 4.3 million. So it's crazy. Obviously, if you're new to the channel and you see the growth and you look back, that main video has really got us to where we are, you know what I'm saying? We're at 5,000. I dropped that video, now we're at 50,000. I think we're at like 56,000 as I'm recording this video. So it's crazy. I said this a lot in my, you know, subscriber special videos, that I seen this happening, you know what I'm saying? It's something I manifested. So while it's unbelievable, it's not too surprising, because I knew it was going to happen one day, but it just happened so fast. The next question also on YouTube is from Tech Ice, something like that, man. He asked, what was your initial dream before YouTube? It was actually art, and it still is. Art and YouTube are my two main things. I haven't made any art in a while, but I'm not giving up on it. That's just something I'm putting on hold while I'm doing my YouTube, and sooner or later, that's definitely going to be, you know, tied in, you know what I'm saying? I'm a artist. I love art. You can see some of my stuff on NKArtist_ on Instagram. Man, I've been posting up there. It's been a little minute since I posted something. I think the last time I posted something was when What If first came out, which was like what, September, early September, late August, something like that. I don't know, but I'm an artist, man. That was the first thing, you know. I want to have a comics and all that, you know what I'm saying, just be a good artist. And one of the dreams, like my just a big dream that, you know, comes with YouTube and art, is pretty much, like I said, I want to have a comic. I want to have that comic be a movie adaptation or anime adaptation, and then a game adaptation, and then we're going to play that game on this channel. That's just like the massive big dream that I want to have happen, you know, sometime in my life. The next question, man, is from Tanner Wright. He asks, what kind of dog do you have? Man, I actually have two dogs now, bro. I have a boxer and a pit mix. It's not confirmed, but pretty sure that's what it is, man. We took them up to PetSmart, and as soon as they saw him, I was like, oh, this is a boxer and a pit. Let me show y'all real quick. Golly, this is him right here. He's a big boy, bro. His name is Loki. Show your face, bro. Show your face. Show you might can't see his face, he real black, but this is Loki, man. He is only 4 months, he is a baby, he is this big, man. This who y'all be hearing jingling and stuff in the videos, and sometimes he be crying when he need to go out or something. But this is Loki, big boy. My other dog, man, his name is Prince, man. He is a Jack Russell and a Chihuahua mix of Jack Chi. He's actually asleep right now. He's pretty old. He's turning 10 in like a couple weeks. I think October 17th is his birthday. I forgot. It's been 10 years. And so I'm going to let him go ahead and get his rest, but I'll put some pictures up of him. I got a lot. Next question, man, is from Hey Z over on YouTube, man. He asks, when you're releasing the full song, if you add it to Spotify, you know you got a 1 monthly listener. I'm dead. Now, as far as music, man, and that, you know, I've seen a lot of people saying making a fuel song to the What's Up song I did in the Spider-Man video. that would be funny if I did. I don't know if I want to, but I love music, you know what I'm saying? I don't make music that isn't really a goal of mine or a career path I want to take, but singing covers, singing songs, you know, making a joke out of it, just tripping, you know what I'm saying? I would definitely do that. I was actually thinking, to be honest, I was thinking of either making a Spotify or maybe a SoundCloud, and I just, every now and then, I'll make a cover of a song and I'll drop it up there and let y'all know. I'll make a poll about that later in the future. If y'all want to see that, or, you know, have me make a different profile on SoundCloud or Spotify where I just sing covers and like make a meme out of it, I will for sure do that, man. It's something, you know, a little quick and easy thing. It's not like I'm actually writing a song. I'm just gonna do a cover of some old classic. All right, man, back over on Instagram, man, we got a question from Nate Ibarra. He asked, what's your top 3 favorite video games ever? Sheesh, that is a hard question right there, boy. I tell you what, man, I played a lot of games. I'm only 19. I was born in 02, so obviously I haven't played, you know, some of the classics. I actually have, though. I played some classics, you know, because I love games. So as I'm growing up and I see these older games and retro games, I want to try them out. You know, Pac-Man, OG Pac-Man, Galaga, and all those type of games. I've played those. Those are fire. But as far as my favorite games, top 3, right now I'm just going to tell you, I don't have a top 3. There's no way I can have a top 3, man. I love too many games. So I'm just going to tell y'all some of the favorites I can think off my head right now. First, any of the Assassin's Creed games, man. That was my first franchise that I was like stuck with, you know what I'm saying, for a minute. It's out of those, I'll just say Assassin's Creed 3. That was one of the ones I was like, I gotta have that one. I love Snow in video games, and Connor was just that guy. His real name was Rakatakan Ikatan. So let's say Assassin's Creed 3. I'm just gonna throw in the Nier franchise. Bro, Nier became my favorite game with the soundtrack alone, bro. The soundtrack for Nier, Nier Replicant, Nier Automata, goated. So we got Assassin's Creed 3 or any Assassin's Creed game, the Nier franchise, and then you're saying ever, though. That's the thing, it's so many classics I played. I'm just gonna say the first Spider-Man movie game, man. I had it on the original Xbox. I'm just gonna say that right there, man. It's too many games I love, but those three, I'll just say that. Next question, man, is from Capilac Mike 1. He asks, who would you want to collab with? Anybody, really, you know what I'm saying? I'm a pretty cool guy, I think, you know what I'm saying? Long as the energy and the vibes is right, you know what I'm saying, and we can have a good time, I'll collab with anybody. I've been seeing people saying they want to collab and all that. The main thing with me is time, you know what I'm saying? I just gotta have the time, and a lot of the times I'm trying to do this all myself. I've been doing this myself for, you know, the longest, so I'm kind of used to it. I'm a people person. Like, I'm not shy or anything like that. I would say I'm an introvert. I'm not gonna say I don't mess with people, but I don't go out of my way to just, you know, chat, you know what I'm saying? Like, I had my small circle of friends who was on that same energy like I am, but I don't know. As far as collabing with YouTubers, for sure. As far as some names, Berlizzi, Corey Kenshi, you know what I'm saying? I feel like a Dashy collab would be pretty smooth. Now, those are some big names, but anybody, like I said, you know what I'm saying? Next up, man, is from Balowski. Yes, have you played any of the games in the Batman Arkham series? And that's crazy that you asked that, because not too long ago, I actually re-downloaded Batman Arkham Knight, because as you know, if you're a DC fan, now, let me tell y'all this. I'm a big Marvel fan. DC, I have no problem with DC, but I never got into their movies. I didn't really read no comics. Only thing I really was involved with DC was the game, you know, Injustice 2, the Batman Arkham series, and I'm really getting into that series like maybe about 3 years ago. I'm still kind of new to it, but I replayed Arkham Knight not too long ago because I was gonna make some random shenanigans on that, because October 16th DC Fandom is happening, and we're gonna be playing Gotham Knights and Suicide Squad Kill the Justice League on the channel. So I wanted to you know, kind of prepare us for that and play some random shenanigans in the Batman Arkham Knight game. So stay tuned for that. Over on Twitter, man, the big homie Sticky asked me, what city did you grow up in and what slang is your city known for? I'm from Raleigh, bro, you know what I'm saying? My mom is from Newark, New Jersey. I think I got some family out in Brooklyn that I don't even know, honestly. I got a lot of family around that I don't know, but I'm aware of them, but I haven't met them, I guess I should say. But yeah, I'm from Raleigh, North Carolina, y'all. Next up, man, back on Instagram, we got a question from Hey Solo Official, I think I said that right, but he asked, how did you make your profile picture? Once again, I am an artist, I made that myself, man. Drew it up on my sketchbook, took a picture, put that over on my computer, colored it in, boom. I'm actually gonna make a new one with the Naruto headband since we're like officially the shinobi now, so I might make a new profile picture soon, and maybe I'll update y'all and let y'all see the process if that's something y'all interested in. Next question is from Julian. He asks, are you gonna play any horror games anytime soon? Anytime soon, I don't know, but horror games are definitely gonna be on the channel, man. This gaming channel is for all genres, you know what I'm saying, long as it's fire. So any genre to, you know, anime, horror, I think that's in my description, games from anime to horror, you know what I'm saying, it can be any game, and horror is definitely something I want to play. The problem with that, man, is that it seems like majority of the horror games are on PC, and I don't have a good gaming PC right now, so I won't even try to play a game up here. So I'm relying on the PlayStation, and there's really not too much that I haven't already played. That's the thing, I never want to replay a game and fake a reaction, especially with a scary game. Like, I'll replay games, but scary games, when you know when a jump scare is gonna happen, I don't know about that. I feel like that wouldn't be too entertaining. But I think a new Outlast is coming out. I definitely want to play that. And yeah, man, any scary game that's coming out on consoles and, you know, that I see, we gonna play. Next question is from Sod FPS. He asked me, am I in college? No, I graduated 2020, right during the pandemic, man. Like I said earlier, once I had that opportunity, I was home. You know what I'm saying, I started working on my career, you know what I'm saying, and from that point on, it's just been going up, and I have, you know, complete faith in myself, and I believe in my craft and all that. My mom and my sister believe in me, you know what I'm saying, and it's really them, you know what I'm saying, because most cases when you see an 18-year-old and 19-year-old, they're already in college, you know, they got to move out, got a house, yada yada yada. I'm fortunate and blessed enough to still be at home and, you know, building myself up before I get out, you know what I'm saying. So shout out to my mom and all that believed in me and, you know, let me take this time to build myself up before I'm out, you know what I'm saying. Drayvon Love asked me who is my favorite YouTubers. Burleazy, Corey Kenshin, Rad Brad. I said that earlier, but I'm gonna talk about that just a little bit. Burleazy was actually the first YouTuber that I started watching him when he pretty much started. That's like the only YouTuber I've been with since the beginning, you know what I'm saying, back when he was wearing glasses and his skin, you know, when he was in college, you know what I'm saying, in the garage days and all that. Like, I think I seen a couple of his videos a little before, like right before he started doing the Exposed series, so I've been there for a minute, you know what I'm saying. I was like, shoot, I don't know, man, I want to say maybe 12, I don't know, I was young, man, when I started watching Burleazy, bro. And yeah, I was the whole Exposed series, when he made the gaming channel, when he played Outlast, up until now, man. I am a big EGHQ, Easy Gang affiliate. I am that guy, bro. The next one would probably be Rad Brad, for sure. I guess he would be another YouTuber that I've been with. I wouldn't say the beginning, I think it was around GTA 5 when I discovered his, no, Assassin's Creed. I think it was Assassin's Creed series. I started watching him. I was pretty young as well when I watched the Rad Brad, so it's cool kind of growing up with him because he's like 30 something now, has a daughter, so that's pretty fire. He's actually the inspiration that I want to end up going to on my channel, like as a the final destination for the channel. Obviously, you know, we got millions of shinobis on the channel, you know what I'm saying, and being able to just play any game or just make a video called Grape Juice and then, you know, everybody comes together and we just have a good time and still gets views and all that, I feel like that's the end thing. Rad Brad is like, you know, he's that guy, you know, he plays any game. I don't know, Rad Brad is a cool dude, definitely an inspiration. Another question from K Bucks, man. He asked, what was your old job before YouTube? I had two jobs, like real jobs. Well, this is a real job, but a actual working job before YouTube, man. My first job was sophomore year in high school, man. I was a youth counselor, man. I was a youth counselor, Raleigh Summer Youth, man. I was out there for about I think it was the whole summer, you know, then I went into my junior year. That was a cool little job, you know what I'm saying. I didn't think I would really work good with kids, but like I said, I'm a cool guy, I'm an introvert, but I'm cool with people, you know what I'm saying, as long as they cool with me, I'm cool with you. So I was cool with the kid. Next job was whack, you know what I'm saying. I was working at Old Navy in my senior year. That was horrible. I was there for like, I don't know, a month. It was a winter season. I think I started in like late October, maybe early November, end up quitting like right before Christmas, you know what I'm saying. They was trying to get me to work up there Christmas, like Christmas Eve or Christmas Day or something like that, to like 3 a.m. or 1 a.m. and I was still in school, like I was a senior, yeah, but ain't nobody finna do that. And then like I said, after that I graduated and start grinding hard with my YouTube career. Another question from K-Bucks, he says, do you like doing what you do? Yes, man, I love doing what I'm doing. I'm playing games and making a career out of that. And not only am I playing games, making a career, making money, but I'm entertaining y'all and I'm making y'all laugh and smile. That's probably the best thing I think a person, most people I would hope, you know, to make people smile, you know what I'm saying? I've been getting comments saying I've been making people days. That's a nice thing right there, man. That's a beautiful thing to see. So I love what I'm doing. Yes. Now I'm gonna take you over to TikTok, man. I posted a video asking me some questions. So now let's get into that. So let's see. Can you react to funny vids? This is a question by Jaguar I0. Can I react to funny vids? It was another question I was actually trying to look for, because they was asking me, will I keep doing gaming content or will it be more content? So I'm glad I got this one so I can kind of talk about this. But yes, you know what I'm saying? I actually mentioned this a while ago, but I was thinking about making a new channel called KageSMG Plus, where I do pretty much everything else other than gaming. But as we're growing, maybe y'all, you know, talk about this more in the future, but I want to, y'all let me know if y'all want to have a new channel or we keep everything right here on this one channel. So we can have this channel be for gaming, skits, reacting to funny videos, reacting to movies, music, reacting to horror videos, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, skits. Yeah, I like to do films. That's another thing I like to do, as well as art. Now art, I probably will make a separate channel for art, you know what I'm saying? So I don't want to have KageSMG with my art name. My pen name is NK Artist. But yeah, man, I definitely want to do more content. We got a question from Nathaniel Barnes. He asks, question, you easy gang? Yes, I am. I already mentioned this earlier, but yes, bro. This is a pretty good question from JC the Dream. He says, I gotta ask about how you feel about having most people just ask, comment. How you worded that, bro? He's trying to say, how do I feel about people commenting, just talking about the song I did for the Spider-Man game, since that's what's really blowing me up. Yeah, that is true. I get a lot of comments talking about, you know, what's going? I wake up in the morning. It's cool, you know what I'm saying? It's cool for now, because, you know, it's not like this something I didn't want to do. It would have been different if, because this actually happened, one of my GTA 5 music videos blew up, you know what I'm saying? And everybody, my first audience was for the AMVs and the, you know, the GTA music videos. And when I wanted to switch to gaming, my audience was still for those edits. And I'm like, I don't really want that. But for this, I was a me singing, you know, playing games. That's something that I would want to happen, you know what I'm saying? I want many other clips to blow up and people share my clips around. So it's pretty cool for right now. I do want to say that this, while this is a gaming channel, it's a gaming channel. Don't expect me singing every single time. Singing is something I like to do, not like as a career, but I love music and I'm gonna sing. And you know, that's, I'm just being myself when I record these videos. So if I be singing, I'm gonna be singing, but don't expect a song or, you know, something like that every time, because this is a gaming channel first. Tasty gamer juice, what kind of, bro, what he says, your favorite childhood game? Sheesh, I don't have a favorite because I have played a lot, but I'm just gonna name some. The OG Spider-Man movie game, I had it for the original Xbox. Need for Speed Underground 2, Crash Bandicoot series, Fight Night Round 2, Fight Night Champion. I had 50 Cent Bulletproof, that game was classic, and a lot of others. Oh, here it is, the homie Sticky asked it. Is skit something you might add to your content? Yeah, I mentioned that earlier, but skits and all types of other content I want to do in the future. Rapid_CoreyX asks, do you have a girlfriend or a wife? No, and I really don't plan on it no time soon. I'm focusing, you know, straight, you know what I'm saying, tunnel vision with my career, and that's something definitely I want to have happen in the future, but right now, nah. And all right, y'all, I think I'm gonna end this up right here, man. We're coming in at 30 minutes. Like I said, y'all came with a lot of questions. Now, I wasn't expecting that, you know what I'm saying? I was expecting to get some questions since, you know, I was starting to get more followers on my social media platforms, but y'all hit me with a lot of questions, man. So I want to say thank y'all for that, you know what I'm saying? A lot of good questions, man. Some of them I did skip out. It was a lot of them were duplicates though, but I just want to say to everybody that left a comment, I love y'all, thank y'all. If I didn't mention you on the video, I'm sorry, but I seen it and I appreciate you, man. But this was our first Q&A. I hope it was entertaining. I know I wasn't really doing too many jokes. I did want to kind of just answer these questions truthfully, and yeah, man, this is probably going to be our channel trailer, so for any new subscribers, they can watch this Q&A, kind of get to know about me, about us, and where we're going to go in the future. With that being said, I'll just say this, KageSMG, us, the Shinobis, this channel, this is just the beginning. This is just the very, very beginning. We have a slew of games you're going to be playing. Like I said, more content. I definitely want to switch things up. I never want to be, you know, get stuck doing the same thing. So I want to, you know, spice things up for y'all every now and then. So yeah, I will start doing skits. I'll ask y'all if y'all want to keep everything on this channel or if y'all want a separate channel where we react to it. Everything else and just do everything else other than gaming, art, you know what I'm saying, merch is something we want to do. I got a lot of goals, man. Live streaming, you know, that board I show y'all in my subscriber special videos, that board is where I write all of my goals. And as I got a new mic, I want to get a camera, new PC, live stream, new equipment, 100K, you know what I'm saying? All the games you want to play, I put it on my board and, you know what I'm saying? I pray. I put them on my board, looking at them every day, and I start getting it, you know what I'm saying? So, a lot is going to be happening in the future, you know what I'm saying, man? And yeah, man, it's a lot that I could say. I don't write no script, so I know I keep saying, it's because I'm trying to just think directly off the top of my head, but I'm grateful. I love y'all. I thank y'all. And I'm going to end this up here, man. If you enjoyed any part of this video, do me a favor. Hit the like button. Subscribe if you're new. Hit the bell so you know when I'm posting, man. Share the content. Share the channel. Do all of that. I'll see y'all in the next one. It's your boy, Kai SMG. Peace. Tell me why you did it. Every dream.